Good morning, students. In last class, we have discussed about graphical solution of a pair of linear equations. There we solved few of the problems and we studied without plotting a linear equations in a graph, we can tell that whether the system is consistent, inconsistent and consistent and dependent. On that base, in today's class, we are going to solve exercise 3.2, okay? Only few I am going to solve in this exercise 3.2, okay? Now, see here, first one, form the pair of linear equations in the following problems and find their solutions graphically. We have to find out the solutions graphically. The first sub-question tells us that 10 students of class 10 took a part in a mathematics quiz. Okay, 10 students of a class 10 took a part in a mathematics quiz. If the number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys, okay, find the number of boys and girls who took part in the quiz. Here they have given some condition. By using that conditions, we have to find out the number of girls and the number of boys who took part in the mathematics quiz. So, solution. So, let the number of boys who took part in the mathematics quiz, we don't know, we will take it as a x, okay, and the number of girls who took part in the mathematics quiz B1. Okay, now we will go to according to the condition, 10 students of class 10 took part in a mathematics quiz. Okay, means girls and boys participated in the quiz. Okay. See, according to the given condition, according to the given condition, x plus y is equal to 10. This is equation number 1. Yes or no? 10 students of a class 10 took part in a mathematics quiz. Here the number of girls is x and the number of boys is x and the number of girls is y. Okay. And one more, what they again? If the number of girls is, girls are represented by y. If the number of girls is 4 more than the number of boys, more means addition, right? It will be x plus 4. If it was 4 less than the number of boys, means you would have used x minus 4. More means you have to do addition. Less means subtraction. So this equation can be written as, see here, 4y . So, you will take this at LHS side and this I will take at RHS. Okay. So, this implies x, if I take this side, it will become minus y is equal to minus 4. For this, I will call it as equation number 2. Okay. Now, two equations we got, right? Now, what we are going to do? We are going to put the values of x and we are going to get the corresponding value of y. afterwards that we are going to plot it in a graph. The main intention we have to find out here, the number of girls and boys who took a part, who took part in the mathematics quiz. Now for x plus y is equal to 10, the solutions are, the solutions are here x and y will be 10 minus x. If I take x value 0, what is the y value? 10 minus 0 is 10. Yes, if I take x value 10, what will be the y value? 10 minus 10 is 0. Okay, you can take more than 2 also. Now for x minus y is equal to minus 4, the solutions are, okay, we'll put the value of x, from that we are going to get the corresponding value of what? We are going to get the corresponding value of y. Say here y is equal to x plus 4. If I take x value 0, what is the y value? Y value is going to be 4. If I take x value minus 4, y value is going to be 0. Now we are going to represent this in a graph. So now we are going to plot these points on the graph. Now see, when x is 0, y will be 10. When x is 0, 10. Next is 10, 0. X-axis is 10. Okay, we will plot here and then only up to 5. This 6, 7, 6, 7. When x is 10, y is 0. When x is 10, y is 0. It is 10, 0. Now we are going to join this. Okay, this is a equation x plus y is equal to 10. Now we will go for the equation x minus y is equal to minus 4. When x is 0, y is 4. When x is 0, y is 4. It is 0, 4. When x is minus 4, y is 0. When x is minus 4, y is 0. Now we are going to join these two. Okay, this is the equation of line x minus y is equal to minus 4. Now see here, the graph of two equations are intersecting, means this system has a unique solution. Yes or no? This system has a unique solution. Now we will find what are the solutions are they. Okay, the two lines are intersecting at point here. We will just see. See here, 3, 7 means the two graphs are intersecting at the point 3, 7 means here x is 3, y is 7. Okay, we will write here. The two lines intersect. Yes or no? The two lines intersect at the points 3, 7. So x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 7 is the solution. Is the solution of the pair of linear equations. That is, x we have indicated for, x is for, let x denote the number of boys who took part in the mathematics quiz. That is number of boys is equal to 3 and number of girls is equal to 7. Okay, so this is the way how we are going to represent the linear equations in the graph. If it intersect, we are getting a unique solution. If the graph of two linear equations are parallel, means we don't have a solutions. Okay, if the graph of two linear equations coincide, means we have infinite many solution. Yes or no? Now we will see the second main of this. So second one, on comparing the ratios A1 by A2, comma B1 by B2 and C1 by C2, find out whether the lines representing the following pairs of linear equations intersect at a point are parallel coincident. First one, 5x minus 4y plus 8 is equal to 0. 7x plus 6y minus 9 is equal to 0. Now see here, on comparing the ratios a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2, find out whether the lines representing the following pairs of linear equations intersect at a point, are parallel or coincident. See here students, in last class I told you that without representing it in a graph, we can tell that whether the pair of linear equations are going to be intersect or parallel or coincident by comparing the ratios. Yes or no? See, if a linear equation a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0, then see here, first one, a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, means the pair of linear equation is consistent or inconsistent? Consistent means the pair of linear equation have unique solution, that the graphs are intersecting. Yes or no? Second condition, a1 by b1 is equal to what we can tell here, if the pair of linear equation, the system is consistent, means the lines are what? Intersecting. Yes, the lines are intersecting. Second one, A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2 means the system is what? Consistent or inconsistent? Consistent and dependent. Means the two lines, the lines are what? Coincident. Coincident. Okay. Third condition, if A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2, means the system is inconsistent, means the lines are what? The lines are parallel. Yes. So without plotting it in a graph, we can tell by only by comparing the ratios whether the pair of linear equation is consistent or inconsistent or consistent and dependent. If it is consistent, means the lines are intersecting. If it is consistent and dependent, means the lines are what we are going to tell? Coincident. If it is inconsistent, means the lines are parallel. Okay, by having the idea of this, we will solve the second problem. Now see a solution. Say given 5x minus 4y plus 8 is equal to 0. Equation 1. 7x plus 6y minus 9 is equal to 0. Equation number 2. Say comparing equation 1 and 2 with standard form of pair of linear equation, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Okay. See, we get a1. What is a1? It is 1. B1. What is b1? B1 is minus 4. C1 is 8. Okay. A2 is 7. B2 is 6. C2 is minus 9. Okay. Now see, a1 by a2 is equal to, what is a1? A1 is 5, 5 by 7. B1 by b2 is equal to, what is b1? B1 is minus 4, minus 4 by 6. 2 2s are 4, 2 3s are, the answer will be minus 2 by 3. Since a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Say what we can tell? Here a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2. Here the lines are intersecting. Yes or no? The lines are intersecting. Therefore, both lines are what? Intersecting, yes? Intersecting. This is about second main, okay? Now we will go for the third main question. On comparing the ratios a1 by a2, b1 by b2 and c1 by c2, find out whether the following pair of linear equation consistent or inconsistent. So question 3x plus 2y is equal to 5, 2x minus 3y is equal to 7. Fourth one, 5x minus 3y is equal to 11 minus 10x plus 6y is equal to minus 22. Now see, a student, they ask us whether this pair of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent. When the pair of linear equations are consistent, if a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by b2, okay, and one more is a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. If these From these, any one condition followed means these are consistent. Otherwise, if we got A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2 means the pair of linear equation is inconsistent. See a solution. First one, 3x plus 2y is equal to 5, 2x minus 3y is equal to 7. Call this as equation 1 and this as equation 2. See, on comparing equation 1 and 2 with standard form of pair of linear equation, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. That is a1 is equal to, in place of a1 what is there? 3. In place of a2, okay, we will find out what is B1. What is B1? It is plus 2. In place of C1, see a student, this we are going to, here plus C1 is there, no? We are going to take this side. If it will come here means it will become minus 5, yes? C1 is nothing but minus 5. So, don't write only plus 5. Now, see here. A2 is, according to this equation you go, A2 is 2, B2 is minus 3, C2 is minus 7. Now do A1 by A2, A1 by A2 is equal to 3 by 2. What is B1 by B2? It is 2 by minus 3. 2 by minus 3 is nothing but minus 2 by 3. Now see here. A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. If A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2 means what? The graph of these two linear equations will going to intersect. Means if it intersect means it has unique solution. If it has unique solution means the system is consistent. They are told whether the linear equations are consistent or inconsistent. This is consistent. I told that if A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2 means it will be consistent. If A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2 means it is also consistent and dependent. So what we can write here, since A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2, so the given equations intersect each other at one point and they have unique solution, hence the equations are what? Equations are consistent. Okay, now we will see fourth one in this one. Say fourth one, 5x minus 3y is equal to 11 minus 10x plus 6y is equal to minus 22. Okay, solution. The given equations are 5x minus 3y is equal to 11. Call it as equation number 1. Minus 10x plus 6y is equal to minus 22. This is equation number 2. On comparing equation 1 and 2 with standard form of pair of linear equation, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. That is a1 is equal to 5, b1 is equal to minus 3, c1 is equal to minus 11. Okay, a2 is equal to minus 10, b2 is equal to plus 6, c2 is equal to plus 22. Now we'll compare the ratios. A1 by A2 is equal to 5 by minus 10. Now see here, 5 by minus 10 is nothing but minus 5 by 10. Okay, it will be minus 1 by 2. Now we will compare B1 by B2. B1 by B2 is equal to minus 3 by 6. It will become minus 1 by 2. 3 ones are, 3 twos are. Now we will see C1 by C2. What is C1 by C2? Minus 11 divided by 22. It is minus 1 by 2. Now see here, students. A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. From this what we can tell? The lines will going to be coincident. If the lines are going to be coincide, means it has infinitely many solution. If this has infinitely many solution, means this system is going to be a consistent. Yes or no? We will write here, since A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2, these linear equations are coincident lines and have infinite many solutions. Hence the equations are consistent. Okay, now we will see the next mean. Now see here, students, fourth mean. Which of the following pairs of linear equations are consistent or inconsistent? If consistent, obtain the solution graphically. See here, this is the pair of linear equation. If this is consistent, we have to find out the solution graphically. If it is inconsistent, don't want solution only. Okay, it is inconsistent means we won't get a solution only, right? If it is consistent means we have to obtain the solution graphically. First, we will check whether this is consistent or inconsistent. How to check? By comparing the ratios. Okay, solution. Say given x plus y is equal to 5 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. This is equation 1 and this is equation 2. See, on comparing equation 1 and 2 with standard form of pair of linear equation, that is a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0 and a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. Okay, that is a1 is equal to, here nothing is there, means 1 will be there, no? A1 is 1, B1 is 1, C1 is minus 5. Okay? Next, A2 is 2, B2 is 2, C2 is minus 10. Now we'll compare the ratios. A1 by A2 is 1 by 2, B1 by B2 is 1 by 2, C1 by C2 is minus 5 by minus 10, it will be 1 by 2. Here, since A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2, what we can tell here? The system is consistent or inconsistent? The system is consistent because the lines will going to be coincide. If coincide means it have many solution. If it have many solution means the system is consistent. If it is consistent, we have to solve this in a graph. We have to find out the solution in a graph. Therefore, the equations are coincident and they have infinite solution. Hence, the system is consistent. Now, if the system is consistent, we have to solve this in a graph. Okay. Now, we'll take for the equation x plus y is equal to 5. We will find out the solutions. X, 1. If I take x value 2, what is the y value? 2 plus y is equal to 5. Y is equal to 5 minus 2 is 3. If I take x value 3, y value will be 2. If I take x value 4, y value will be 1. Okay. Now, for the equation, for the equation 2x plus 2y is equal to 10. Now see, if I take x value 2, what is the value of y? 2 2's are 4 plus 2y is equal to 10, 2y is equal to 6, y is equal to 3. If I take x value 3, y value will going to be 2. Okay? If I take x value 4, y value will going to be 1. Okay? Now we will this plot in a graph. We will plot the points. If x is 2, y is 3. If x is 2, y is 3. 2, 3. If x is 3, y is 2. If x is 3, y is 2. 3, 2. If x is 4, y is 1. If x is 4, y is 1. 4, 1. Here also the points we took same because we know that it will going to be coincide. Yes or no? Now see, if I take the same points are there, okay? We knew that it is nothing but coincide. The graph will going to be coincide. You can take different points also and you can check. No problem, it will going to be coincide only. Okay? Now we will see the next main. That is sixth mean. Now see, the sixth question tells us that given the linear equation, one linear equation is given, 2x plus 3y minus 8 is equal to 0. This is one linear equation. Write another linear equations in two variables. We have to write one more linear equation such that the geometrical representation of the pair so formed is intersecting line. We have to find out here. See here. They have given one linear equation, that is 2x plus 3y minus 8 is equal to 0. They have given one linear equation. We have to find out one more linear equation in variable x and y. Okay. In two variables. Such that whatever we are writing the equation, no, that equation should be in such a way that the geometrical representation of the pair so formed is intersecting line. Okay, you have to find out here one more pair of linear equation in such a way that these two equations should be intersecting lines. You know, we know that if A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2 means definitely the lines are intersecting. We have to find a equation in such a way. Okay. So for this intersecting line, see here, it should be what they told? It should be a intersecting lines. So we can find out here the linear equation 2x minus 7y plus 9 is equal to 0. Now see here. For intersecting line, A1 by A2 is not equal to B1 by B2. Now see, A1 is 2, A2 is 2, A1 by A2, this is A1 by A2. It should not be equal to B1 by B2. Okay, this equation is correct. Now in the same way, we will find out for parallel lines. The second they have given for parallel lines. To form a parallel line, what is the condition? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is not equal to C1 by C2. In such a way, you have to find out the one more linear equation. See here, 6x plus 9y minus plus 9. See this? here 2/3, first will 2/3, this is also, now we will check it, okay. Now see, 2/6 is equal to 3/9, okay. 2 1s are 2 3s are 3 1s are 3 3s are, okay. It is not equal to -8/9, yeah. Yes, this is a linear equation for parallel line. What about third one? For coincident, if I write the same equation, 2x + 3y - 8 = 0, because in a coincident, what is the condition? a1 by a2 = b1 by b2 = c1 by c2. See, this completes your exercise 3.2. I solved only few problems. In next class, we are going to see algebraic method of solution of pair of linear equation. Okay, thank you. We will continue in the next class.